Hi guys, it's Chris. It's a fact of life for us who work in SAS that the people we do work for eventually want their output in Microsoft Excel. I know it's sad, but it's true. And today I'm going to show you a few ways in SAS Enterprise Guide that you can get your output from SAS Enterprise Guide out to Excel. Some easy ways. Let's check it out. First thing I want to make you aware of is that not everything that we produce in Enterprise Guide or in SAS is data. Sometimes we produce reports, and I want to first show you how you can share your reports out to Excel right from inside here. So you have here, I have a report up. You can see over on the right. It's got a graph. It's got some tables. It looks pretty cool, but it's an HTML. HTML is the default output format within SAS Enterprise Guide, but that is super easy to change. There's a couple of ways you can change it. You can change it from Tools Options, and under Results, you can pick the output formats that you want to generate. This changes your preference across the application, but for this case, I don't want to do that. I want to change it just for this one piece of output that I'm creating in my program. So I'm going to change it here in a much more local property. In this little button up here, I can view and set properties. And you can see I have a very similar list of results options that we just saw in the general application options. I'm going to go ahead and pick Customize Result Formats and select Excel and unselect, make sure all the other ones are unselected because I just need Excel for this. Committed that by clicking OK, and then I'll click Run, rerun my output. Now, Enterprise Guide doesn't show you the contents of an Excel file, but it does show you that the Excel file was created. So I can just double click on this output here and bring it up in Excel, and you can see the result. And there it is. I just transferred that report no longer in HTML. Now it is inside my Excel sheet, and I've got actually three sheets, one per SAS procedure that I used. I want to show you really quick how you can adjust even this. I'm going to go ahead and close that. And with a little bit of code inside Enterprise Guide, you can change some of the options for how this Excel file is generated. I'm not going to go into all the possible options. There's so many of them in the ODS Excel format. But I'm going to go ahead and select sheet intervals to none, which means there will not be a break or new sheets created in between SAS procedures. And I want to go ahead and customize the sheet name to be shows for my report. So I'll just run that report again. And like that, it is done. And I'll just open that up. And you'll see now, instead of having three sheets, I've got everything all in one sheet, all in a row. So that's one simple way to get report output out. A lot of times, though, we have just data that we're dealing with in SAS, and people just want the data to their Excel file. So over here, I have a simple SAS data set, just has a few columns. The simplest way, the one I use the most often when I need to create an Excel file, is I click on the Share button. In earlier versions of Enterprise Guide, you'll find these options, Send To and Export. You'll find them listed in other menus. There's a specific Send To menu and a specific Share or Export menu. But here in version 8.1 and later, we'll find them under the Share menu. So I'm going to go ahead and click Send To Excel, Microsoft Excel. And what that does is it actually automates Microsoft Excel. You'll see the Excel application come up, and it isn't actually saved to an Excel file. It just created a new Excel session for me and then put all of the data inside of it. I use this a lot because oftentimes I need to do some extra steps before I go ahead and share this with other people. Like I might go ahead and select the rows here and make them, the row header, make it bold, or do some other, add some other Excel-like features just to, as an extra service to the people who I'm creating this for. And then I would use File Save to save the Excel file out to where I want it to be and share that out. That's the one I use most often. I can also use export, or sometimes export as a step. Those two do basically the same thing, except they only differ in that export just actually just writes out to an Excel file. You browse and pick which file, you know, the location and name of the file you want to create. Export as a step does the same thing, but it encodes it into the project, if you're using an Enterprise Guide project, so that every time you run that project, that file is created again. I'm not going to show you all of those. Those are pretty straightforward. But the last tip I want to show you is a very simple copy and paste. So let's look at, sometimes I don't want to share all of the data to Excel, but only part of it. I can select any of the data. I can either select all of it by just selecting over here in the left corner and select the whole data set. If this is a lot of columns or a lot of rows, maybe I don't want to do that because it can be take up too much memory. But let's pretend I'm going to pick just a few of them. And I'm going to go ahead and bring up an Excel session. And back to Enterprise Guide, select my records, right click, and select copy with headers. What this does is it puts the content I've selected on the Windows clipboard as a tab delimited set of values. So copy with headers, bring it back over to my Enterprise Guide or to my Excel worksheet, and I can just paste that in. Excel knows what to do with tab delimited data. It just does the right thing and puts it, breaks them up into columns and rows. And so you've got data now instantly in a sheet. Here's another bonus tip. Oftentimes people just want this in email. And if you have, you know, if you use a tool like what I do, usually Microsoft Outlook, it's basically just like a Word document inside email. You can paste those values inside, right inside your email or your Word document. And this doesn't look beautiful when you just paste it in, but since it is tab delimited, you can use built-in features in the editor here to insert a table and convert text to table and just take the defaults that are already detected that these are tab delimited. Click OK. And then you can use some of the cool features within your email editor or Word to format that table for you. And then you've got it all nice and pretty before you send it on to your constituent. So that's how you, just a few ways that you can share content from SAS Enterprise Guide out to Excel to share it with other people. I hope you liked this video. There are related links in the description. Please leave me some comments. I'd love to hear what you think. And if you want more tips like this, be sure to subscribe to our channel. Thanks, see you next time.
Should I subscribe to this channel? Yes, you should. Is it worth it? Absolutely.